वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर चैप्टर आस्किंग यस आर नो क्वेश्चंस। ए ग्रेटर पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन कम्युनिकेशन कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस। क्वेश्चंस आर यूज्ड टू एलिसिट और गेट इंफॉर्मेशन। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन इंग्लिश, यस आर नो क्वेश्चंस एंड WH क्वेश्चंस। Yes or no questions are questions which are answered either by a simple yes or no. Mastering these two types of questions will be of great help to you. Many people make mistakes while framing questions in English due to the influence of their mother tongue or their inability in mastering the word order in questions. Read the following passage and identify and underline the words that help you to make questions. Birds are warm-blooded vertebrates. There were flying reptiles before feathered birds. The oldest feathered bird was the Archaeopteryx. Most birds can fly. India has nearly 1200 species of birds. The largest Indian bird is the great bustard. We should protect birds. We must take care of even the common crow. Our children will thank us for this. So from this, you have to identify the sentences to frame questions. Birds are warm-blooded vertebrates. Vertebrates means spinal cord, having spinal cord. So there were flying reptiles before feathered birds. Most birds can fly. We should protect or we should take care of even common crow. Our children will thank us for this, like that. So here, observe how sentences are converted into yes or no questions. First one, most birds can fly. Can most birds fly? That is question. Next statement. Birds are warm-blooded vertebrates. Question. Are birds warm-blooded vertebrates? Third statement. She is reading a book. Question. Is she reading a book? Next statement. We should protect the birds. Should we protect the birds? What you understood here? Here, we just changed the helping verb position. See, most birds is subject, can helping verb, fly. So the main concept in this, to frame yes or no questions, we have to move the place, change the place. Generally, we write helping verb after the subject in the statement, but in questioning, we write the helping verb before subject. So, we change it to here. We change it the place. Most birds can fly. Can most birds fly? question mark. Like this. So, can most birds fly? Next, second one. Birds are warm-blooded vertebrates. Here, birds, subject, are helping verb. Warm-blooded vertebrates. Warm-blooded vertebrates. Here, to change into question, we have to move the place of helping verb. Are birds warm-blooded vertebrates? See. Are birds warm-blooded vertebrates? Next. She is reading a book. She, subject, is helping verb. Verb, a book. So change the helping verb position. Is she reading a book? Is she reading a book? Next, we should protect the birds. We, subject, should, helping verb, protect verb, the birds, subject. Change the helping verb position, place. Should we protect the birds? Question mark. So this is another activity. You have to do that. Here, I do not panic. I do not panic. Do I panic? I may lose my sense of direction. May I lose my sense of direction? I will pay close attention to my surroundings. Change the position. Will I pay close attention to my surroundings? I can easily know the way out. Change the position. Can I easily know the way out? Question mark. Someone is searching for me. Change the position, helping word. Is someone searching for me? Question mark. I will blow the whistle. Change the position of helping word. Will I blow the whistle? Question mark. So, study the word order of yes or no questions. In yes or no question, the question is formed by placing the first helping verb. First helping verb. It's very important. First helping verb before the subject. The helping verb indicates whether the sentence refers to the past, present, or future time. If the helping verbs are am, is, are, that is present. Was, were, past, will, future. Right. Has, have, present, had, past. ING continuation form. V3 perfect form. Here is the structure. Am, is, are. Subject, I, he, she, it, we, you, they. The subject I takes the helping verb am. In third person. He, she, it, third person singular, take the helping verb is. We, you, they takes the help, take the helping verb are. So frame now. I am late. Change into question. Am I late? He is late. Is he late? She is late. Is she late? It is late. Is it late? I am going. Am I going? In that way. Is he going? Is he writing? Are we late? Are we going? Are we writing? In that way. Next, verbs were. Suppose I, he, she, it. These take the helping verb was. And remaining we, you, they take helping verb were. I was eating. Change into question. Was I eating? So, was I eating? Was he eating? Was she eating? Was it eating? Next verb. Suppose sentence statement. We were working. Change into question. Were we working? Were you working? Were they working? You have to frame sentences and write in your notebook. This is an for a table. Next, see the activity 2. Here, make questions using the words given below. Your sisters well? Change into question. Yes or no type question. You have to write helping word. Are your sisters well? Question mark. Near here the hospital. So the helping word must be singular because the hospital is singular. So is the hospital near here? Question mark. The college open today? Is the college open today? Next, interested in computer? You. Are you interested in computer? Very strict he. Is he very strict? Question mark. Coming, the bus. Is the bus coming? Your friends watching television. So your friends is subject, that is plural. Are your friends watching television? Question mark. You listening to me. Subject is you. So helping verb are. Are you listening to me? Why I have taken are? Because listening is continuous form. In present continuous, we take the helping verb are. Are you listening to me? Question mark. Next, do, does, did are used when there is no auxiliary or helping verb. There is no auxiliary or helping verb means am, is, are, was, were. If they are not present, we use do, does, did. In simple present tense, we use do, does. In simple past tense, we use did. Understood? I explained in the chapter of our tenses chapter. Do, does, did. Subject. Main verb. Okay, after do, does, did, we have to write verb first form only. In simple past tense also, if you write did, don't write verb second form. Okay, do, I, you, we, they. Generally, I, we, you, they take the helping verb do. That means in the sense of do, does, which one you take? Do. Next, if the subject he, she, it, we take does. Do I work here? Do you work here? Do we work here? Do they work here? Do I live here? Do you live here? Do we live here? Do they live here? Do I like music? Do you like music? Do we like music? Do they like music? Does he work here? Does he live here? Does he like music? Does he play cricket? Does she work here? Does she live here? Does she like music? Does she play cricket? In that way. In the past tense, did is used with past simple to ask questions. When did is used, the verb changes to present tense. Just I explained. When you write did, don't write verb second form. You have to write verb first form only. Did plus I, subject I, we, you, they, he, she, it. If the subject is first person singular or first person plural, second person singular, second person plural, third person singular, third person plural, whoever it may be, whichever it may be, we have only one helping verb, that is did. So did I go, did I play, did I jump, did we go, did we play, did we jump, did you play, did we go, did you play, did you jump, did they go, did they play, did they jump, did he go, did he play, did he jump, in that way. You have to write, frame sentences and write in notebook. Next, change the given sentence into questions. Write questions with do or does. The first one has been done for you. She likes music. Change into question. This is simple present tense. Here, we have no auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs, I just be forms, I said. Be forms. Not auxiliary, be forms. What are the be forms? Am, is, are, was, were. If there is no auxiliary be form is there, we take do, does, did. Here, she likes music. This is simple present tense. Here, no be form. So, we have to take either do or does. Which one comes here? If the subject is third person singular, we take does. If the subject is not a third person singular, we take do. See, a third person singular, subject is third person singular, she. She likes music. So, we write, does she like music? After writing does, we should not add s or s to verb first or verb form. I already explained in the tenses chapter. When we write does, we should not add s or s to verb. Okay, he speaks Hindi. Here also, there is no be form. What are the be forms? Am, is, are, was, were. So, we have to take auxiliary verbs, that means helping verbs, so do or does. Which one comes here? Here, subject is third person singular, he. So, we take the helping verb does. Does he speak English? We have to remove S. So, does he speak Hindi? Next, they pray every morning. Here also, there is no be form. So, they is third person plural. We take the helping verb do. So, we write before subject. Here we write do. Do after, we have to write small letter. Do they pray every morning? Question mark. Next, you sing. Here also, you is second person. We have to take do. Do, after that, you should be small letter. Do you sing? Question mark. Next, you sing well. Here also, there is no be form. So, we, according to the subject you, we take do. Do you sing well? Question mark. Next, we go to the movies often. Here also, there is no be form. Am, is, or was, were. So, according to the subject, our subject is first person plural. So, do. Write do. Do we go to the movies often? Question mark. Next, I admire Gandhi. Here also, there is no be form. Am, is, or was, were. So, according to subject I, we take the helping verb do. Do I admire Gandhi? Question mark. She visits her parents regularly. Here, there is no be form. Am, is, or was, were. So, according to the subject, subject is third person singular. So, we take the helping verb does. Does she visit? Yes, we have to remove because we have written here does. Does she visit her parents regularly? Question mark. He loves to cook. Here also there is no be form. So according to the subject, he does comes. Does he love to cook? Question mark. Next, our cat likes milk. Here there is no be form. So, according to the subject, subject is our cat. Our cat. How many cats are there? Only one cat is there. Our cat, singular. So helping verb does, very very important this one, does our cat. The real subject is not our, real subject is our cat. Cat is subject, real subject is cat. Our cat is singular, not our cats. Our cat is singular, third person singular. So does our cat like, so we have to remove yes, like milk question mark, right? I think you understood well. Next, see, change the given sentence into questions. Write questions with a did. See, did, first one has been done for you. He enjoyed the party. Here there is no be form, am, is, or was, were. So simple verb second form is there, enjoyed. So this is simple past tense. In simple past tense we take the helping verb did. He enjoyed the party. So we write did before subject. What is the subject? He. Did he enjoyed, not enjoyed, enjoy. Why? Because we have written here the helping verb did. When we write helping verb did, we should write verb first form only. Did he enjoy the party? I liked the book. Here also, I liked, simple past tense. So only one helping verb is there. Subject is singular, or subject is plural, or subject is first person, second person, third person, whatever it may be. The helping verb only one is did. So did I, not liked. Did I like the book? Because I just explained, when you write did, you should write verb first form only. Did I like the book? Question mark. She slept late. Slept. Slept is verb second form. Sleep, slept, slept. So, did she, after writing did, she, yes, small letter, should be small letter. Did she sleep late? Question mark. I just explained why it is sleep, not slept. Next, they ate the food. So, simple past tense. Did they eat, first form, eat. Did they eat the food? Question mark. Next, we went to a movie. Did we, after writing did, we have to write where first form. Went first form, go. Go, went, gone. Did we go to a movie? Question mark. The accident took place in the morning. Took place, simple past tense. So, subject is the accident. Did the accident take place? Took, first form is take. Take, took, taken. Did the accident take place in the morning? Question mark. She visited her friend. Here also visited, simple past tense. She visited. Did she, yes, small letter. In the accident also, while writing question form, after did in D cap letter. Did the accident, the small letter, T small letter. So in the beginning only we write capital letter. In the middle we should not write capital letter. I know, I think you know. Did she visit her friend? Next, you sent a message. Send, sent, verb second form. So simple past tense. Here only one helping verb is there. Did you send, first form. Did you send a message? Why? Should be small letter. Because it is in the beginning of the sentence, we write cap letter. We begin with did. So, D is capital letter. After that, Y is small letter only. Did you send a message? Question mark. Next, common errors. What kind of mistakes generally we can make? Did they came yesterday? Just I explained. After writing did, we have to write verb first form only. Did they came yesterday? This is wrong. Did they come yesterday? Next, did you wrote the test I just told you. Did you write the test is right? Does you love cricket? How is it is right? Because you is second person. In simple present tense, we write does when the subject is third person singular only. Remaining take the helping word do. So, do you love cricket is right. Does they want money? I just told you. Third person singular only take the helping verb does. They is third person plural. So, do they want money? Question mark. Did you saw the picture? Same question. Same pattern. Did you see the picture? Because they did here presented. So, to learn more about questioning, observe how questions are asked in interviews, in newspapers, and on television. Okay, here is an activity assignment. Look at the following statements and frame yes or no questions. Here, statement: he is a gentleman. Change into question: is he a gentleman? See here. While changing the sentence into question, the statement is, here he is a gentleman, he cap letter, but we change into question form. So helping verb change at the position. The sentence began with is, so the helping verb is, is cap letter. After that, he small letter, because it is the middle of the sentence. Is he a gentleman? Question mark. He will present the lesson. Will he present the lesson? Question mark. She writes well. So this is simple present tense. There is no be form. So do, does, did. Which one comes? She writes well is simple present tense. So do, does. Which one particularly? Subject is third person singular. So does. Does she write? After writing does, we have to remove yes. To where? Does she write well? Question mark. She is a great leader. Here is be form. Is. So is she a great leader? Question mark. We finished the work. Here there is no be form. So this is simple past tense. Finished is past. So in the past tense we have did. So did we finish the work? So sentence begins with cap letter. D-I-D, did. D is cap letter. After that, we should not write W as cap letter because it is the middle of the sentence. Did we finish the work? You have paid the fee. Have you paid the fee? We can see the church. Can we see the church? You need money. Here there is no be form. So, need is present form. You need money. Simple present. So, subject is you. So we write it do. Do you need money? They read a lot. Okay. Maybe they read a lot. If you feel read, past, did they read a lot? We have to write. Or if you feel it is a simple present, do they read a lot? Question mark. You are a good driver. Change the question. Change into question. Helping verb are. Are you a good driver? Question mark. Next assignment 2. Write 10 yes or no questions that you would like to ask your friend. In examination, this question may come. You have to write ask questions, 10 questions, yes or no questions. Are you going to college today? Have you finished your homework? Have you had your lunch? Has your father given you money? In that way, you have to ask questions. Yes or no questions. Either write something worth reading, sir. Okay, this is a quotation. Okay, I hope you understood well. Listen it once again, see it once again, understand well. And better luck. I wish you best of luck for your exams. A second part, WS type questions will come shortly. Video will come shortly. I will prepare video. Okay, all the best.